Hello there, my name's Gilbert. I'm going to do a Ron Woods for Dummies again. I'm going to do Miss Judy's Farm from As Nods As Good As A Wink to A Blind Horse, 1971. One of my favourite ever albums, this one. It's a must have in anybody's collection. A wee shout out to people that I know. Gigi, Gordon Graham, left us to go to Australia. I've got another friend, Casper, from Switzerland, lives in New York now. Hi, Cuckoo Man. And Jeff Trombo, aka Jan Murph. Now, Jeff, you may have a bit of a problem hearing this because I know you're missing you're missing part of your ear. So, hello, Jeff! Right, I like doing Ron Wood stuff because it was something I grew up with as a child. Just loved them. And me and my mates, we used to get the older boys to go to the shops and get us bottles of sherry, and we used to sit and drink sherry and listen to The Faces when we were kids, so I kind of hold that dear in my heart. I've never met Ron Wood. I don't think I would like to, because they say never meet your heroes. But if, for example, if you were to send me VIP tickets to go and see the Rolling Stones, I would certainly come and meet you. But if you ever see this, Ron Wood, I've seen you playing Miss Judy's Farm with McFucknell. You don't use a Stratocaster. It's no good. You need a dirtier sound than a Strat. You should know better. It's your song. Anyway, I first learned this on an acoustic guitar with nylon strings. So I'll start off showing you how I learned to play Miss Judy on a Bata Gold classical guitar. Then I'll show you how I play it on an electric guitar, which is this small object of desire. I've been trying to get a Les Paul for years and years and years, and always managed to put a little bit of money aside, but something would happen to me, like my van would blow up, so I need to get a new engine for it. I would need to bail my boys out of jail. I would need to pay off my daughter's blackmailers. But my lovely wife, over the years, put a couple of quid away here and there, and she saved up and saved up and saved up, and she bought me this Les Paul. So I really thank her for that. But as luck has it, the guitar turned up on a Tuesday, and the divorce papers that I sent her turned up the next day, so I won all round on that one. Yeah, I'm only kidding. But anyway, I'll continue with the lesson, and I hope you like it. And I got a wee bit of effort. Now, I'm just trying to share what limited knowledge on the guitar that I do have. And you always get these people that leave bad comments on YouTube or the thumbs down. Well, I say to you, before you do it, these are a bunch of wankers. You get on YouTube and do something. Now, what else have I got to say? All right. My demographics on YouTube, I notice that most of the people that look at my channel are American. America's a huge country, and we know you haven't got a really, really good grasp on geography. So, I'm from Scotland, and to let you know where Scotland is, if you ever look at a map and you see Australia on a map, just below Australia there's a big island. That's Scotland. So our nearest neighbours are Australians, and 50 miles to the east we have China. So we're near China and we're near Australia. So that's just to let you know where Scotland is. Right, I'm going to crack on with the lesson just now, so you'll need to excuse me while I set it all up. Okay, here we are. I'm going to show you the kind of acoustic version I learned first. Then if I've got, I don't know how long I'm going to have on this video, so if I don't fit it all in, I can do a second one. But a wee tip for you, say, when you're playing this song, is to learn to get your plectrum like this, and when you're not using your plectrum on this, slide it into your finger like that. It's hard to say. So you can use these two fingers to pluck strings. Then you can grab your plectrum back, so it's just a case of tucking it under your middle finger, and you can grab it back again. I learned that trick off David Copperfield. What I might have to apologise through the song is you probably hear my heavy breathing because I'm very close to the microphone. The reason I breathe so heavy, that's another story. I was playing cricket years and years ago with a boy called Stephen Dow, and we ended up arguing, so he smashed me right in the face with a cricket bat and he broke my nose. So now one of my nostrils is completely blocked. And I suppose that's maybe just God's way of saying that Scottish people just shouldn't play cricket and leave it to the English. But anyway, here's the tune. So we start up on the 5th fret. And I'm only going to play 3 strings. Right? So I'm going to pluck the E. The A and the D, so it's a hammer-on. Then when you get the rest of the tune, it's more upstrokes. So it goes like this, I'll try and show you. And what you try and do with the tune is get... So you're putting pressure on and off the strings, like that, to cut the notes, to stop them ringing out, and getting a... Right, so that's the best I can explain it to you. So, the start is a hammer. Right, so I'm hitting the A and the D. And upstroke, I'm hitting the G and the D. So you get this. That's what makes that song up. So. Right, then it does, it's kind of lifting your finger off and on the hammers and pull off, so. Apologise for it because I'm sitting on the edge of this bloody seat and it's knackered, so I'm sitting with a great big bit of wood basically in my arse. So anyway, that's that. Bugger that up. I'm not going to edit this, but I'm just going to do this mistakes and all. So right, now we go on to the next part. I'll shift the guitar. If you go up to the 5th fret and play and a hammer on, or you could do a slide. So shift again to make this easier. I'm going to turn the guitar a bit, get it all on the screen. The next wee rhythm section goes like this. You do the same, then you bring this finger down and an upstroke. Okay, so then it goes to the D and it does a hammer on. where you get. So try and get. So another wee bit. And you get this. Try and show that another way. Try and piece that all together. It sounds pretty crap, but you just can play it in the song. I'm actually nervous, look. I'm shaking a bit. This is strange. Right, I'm not going to go all the way through the song. But I'm not recording this again. Okay, so where are we? Right, so. Okay, there's that part of it. Now, where are we? There's a wee run on it where it goes. Right. This bit you use vibrato on. So. Next, there's this bit played. It's basically it's a D, but slide it up to the 7th fret and go. Use your pinky. Right, this is where I now grab this plectrum. That's, by the way, that looks like nicotine stains from smoking roll-ups. Well, it's not. I'm a lazy bugger and I just don't learn to wipe my arse clean properly. So anyway, plectrum there, and we're going to pluck the open D string and the E string, so it goes like this. Playing the 3rd fret on the E string, and we're playing the open D, and it goes. And you bring your plectrum back into play and go. So that goes like this. Just lightly pluck the D string. Builds up to then get to the second guitar solo. So what you can do is it goes like this, it does this, sorry. Now you can play it like this. for its beats up, Miss Judy, right? Now for the wee guitar solo bit at the end. Starts here, it goes. Right, so. Then again, grab the plectrum. Then it does this, plucking the D string and the right. This is really difficult to teach somebody like that because I'm having to normally when I play this I don't think about it. So basically, so I'll try and go over a wee bit. A kind of hashy version of it, but that's how I learned to play it on acoustic. How much time is left on this? Right, now okay, so you can play it there and, but this time another wee runs in. Slightly out of tune guitar, but. And you can also. Same as now, oh, I hate the second guitar solo goes. I'm going to move again. Well, there's also other wee runs in it. There's a bit in it, it goes. I'm going to show you how I kind of think the second guitar solo goes like this. Now, this is where this open D string comes into play. So, right, so the second guitar solo goes. There we go. I'll show you this bit. Thank you. up here. Play the... So you're plucking these two strings together. Playing there. Alright, so. Right, now the end bit again is using these. So it goes. Right, I'll show you that again. You can use double stops here if you like. Then it does this. Try that once again. And there's also another wee bit and a wee riff that goes, how is it? This what I showed you earlier, how it goes, play the same up here. Shite. Right. So, Miss Judy's Farm, you can play it like this. That's about it. A bit of a harsh lesson, but if you stick these things together, I'm sure you can learn the tune yourself. I can talk the talk, but when it comes to playing... Maybe show you this bit again. I didn't make that cell clear. So, what you can do here as well. That's another dummy's lesson by a dummy. So, he's going to leave me feedback on that, see how yous get on with the song. I'm sure if you put some time and a wee bit of effort into that, yous will get the tune. Bye.